action, but not like in general. Just mostly this one moment that was like my favorite part of the 2016 election. Jeb Bush. Do you guys know Jeb?
Yeah.
Right, okay, so yeah. So he was like giving a speech and he was like, these are my Republican policies. And everybody was like, yeah, we're like white and old, so like Jeb Bush. And then he said something that was supposed to be really fantastic and like everybody was gonna like clap and roar and be really excited. And then he was like, he said his thing and everyone was like, and then he said, please clap. No, I'm not talking anymore. So that was my favorite moment of the 2016 election. Go Jeb Bush, 2020? I don't know.
Yeah.
So obviously I'm not like a comedian, per se. I also don't really know how to play this part. Okay, so I'm not a comedian. I don't do stand-up comedy, this is my first time, and everyone's looking at me, it's like so scary. Could you guys just like imagine being in a room full of people and they're all looking at you and you're just, oh my god, that's teaching me. Okay, so, I'm not a comedian, I'm like a storyteller.
Yeah.
I'm like a professional storyteller.
Yeah.
And I would love to tell you a story today. So today, I got an eyebrow piercing.
Oh.
Yeah.
This is new. Obviously, I'm very edgy. Thank you, Jane. I got an eyebrow piercing. I could have done it in Kosovo, but I guess I was a little nervous. It was gonna be fine. Anyway, just for the moment, lunch break, we got our eyebrows pierced. So we go downtown. And we go to this one place, and the place isn't open, and then we go to this other place, and this really disinterested woman with like fuchsia eyeshadow is just like on her MacBook. And we're like, hello? Like, you know when you walk in somewhere and you're like from America and you like don't speak Bulgarian? Or, like, you walk in, okay, this is what I do every time I go, hi. I'm sorry. I'm like apologizing for like years of imperialism. Whatever. So basically we go to this one place. She's like, no, we only do tattoos, we don't do piercings, great, good job, fine. Oh, you could go to this other place. It's called Fabric of Pain. Sure, I would love to go to Fabric of Pain to get my eyebrow pierced. Like, that's fantastic. Let's go. Sure. Okay. Okay. Go this way. It's this way. Okay, so we go to Fabric of Pain, we're there. We walk in, we get buzzed in, we go in, blah, 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 blah. Is it this door? No. Is it up this door? No, where is it? Oh, it's this door. It's this weird narrow door. Okay. Okay, hold the mic in one place. Literally, what? Okay. So we go in, it's this one man, and he's tattooing this woman's entire back, and he's doing the whole thing, and we do the, hello. And he does the, you know what I'm talking about? And they're like, oh my god. And then, and we're like, hi, we want eyebrow piercings. And he was like, both of you? And we were like, yeah. And he was like, now? And we were like, yeah. So he's like, okay. And he gets his phone, and he's like, bah, 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 Bulgarian, 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 Bulgarian. Sorry, I have no idea. Sorry. Bulgarian hangs up the phone. 2 minutes. And we're like, oh, okay. What is that? Okay. So we sit down, we're hanging out, this guy comes in. And he comes in, and he starts breathing like this. Sorry, that was louder than I thought it was going to be. So he's breathing like that, and I'm like, is he okay? Like, is he fine? Can you give us piercings? He shows us the eyebrow piercings. A lot of things get lost in translation. Everything's fine. Everything's fine. And then he does this thing where he walks into the piercing room and he goes like this. I'm like, what is this? What does that mean? Does that mean like come with me or like? my arm is like itchy, and I thought about scratching it, but I didn't. I don't know. So he's like, huh? And then we're like, oh, we should follow him, obviously, sure. And then we walk in, and he's like, no, no, absolutely not. Okay, go back out. We go back in. And then he puts something on my face, and then he puts another thing on my face, and then he puts a third thing on my face, but this time it smells like dill pickles. I don't know why. Maybe it's clean. It smells like pickles. And then he just, he's like putting dots on my face. I like look in the mirror, I'm like, I don't know, where else would you, yeah, fine, that looks good. He's like asking my opinion, like I like have any stake. I don't, it's my face, obviously. Okay, anyway, so I'm like, sure, the dots look good. Like, stick a needle in my face, I don't care. Like, I'm 23 years old, and somehow I'm in Sofia, and I don't know what is going on. Okay, so I'm sitting down, and it's like, oh my god, it's that moment where, right before you get a tattoo or right before you get a piercing, where it's like, whoa, like, things are really gonna change from here on out. Like, I'm like drastically changing my appearance, which means, like, when I look in the mirror every day, it's gonna look totally different. When people look at me, they're gonna see me differently. Like, what does that mean for me? Like, as a woman, like, walking through the streets of, like, the Balkans, like, what, my self-image, my heart is pounding. I'm not thinking this at all. I'm actually thinking, but will it hurt? Like, oh my god, I'm so scared. Oh no. Okay. And then, okay, this man who doesn't know any English except for no English, perfectly says, I would just like to remind you that we are at the fabric of pain. He perfectly says, no pain, no gain. I'm like, of every American phrase, of every English phrase, you really nailed that one. Good job, sir. Please clap. Anyway. I like to think that I got an eyebrow piercing today, but really we all got an eyebrow piercing.